استهداف
الدبابة.
A warm climate by the sea, Mediterranean food and lifestyle, a high ranking on the Global Peace Index. What's not to like about Portugal? Investors have been signing up for the Portugal Golden Visa program for years and for a variety of reasons, especially investors from mainland China. Now investment advisors are getting interest from Hong Kong residents too.
What is interesting is the main driver for all investors is not only for Hong Kong, it's for all investors around the world, is to have a plan B in life. And plan B also is in many cases related to having children or giving their children the possibility of studying or working or living in Europe.
Hong Kong residents unhappy about China's new national security law is another reason they're looking for a plan B, say investment advisors. But it's not just Chinese nationals who are interested in Portugal.
We have countries from South Africa, from Turkey, from Brazil. So it's very spread. You can, nowadays with in the US, we have a lot of American clients coming to Portugal. It's unbelievable the amount of Americans that has been coming to Portugal.
To get a residency permit leading to citizenship in roughly 5 years, an investor can create a company which offers jobs, buy or renovate property, or invest in a range of capital funds. But on January 1st, 2022, changes are coming to the program. For example, the amount required to subscribe to an investment fund will go up from 350,000 euros to 500,000 euros. And there's more.
In the investment route, so for instance, capital transfer that until the end of the year will be 1 million euros, it will be raised to 1.5 million euros. In terms of the property route, the properties located in Lisbon, Porto and the coast will be excluded from the program. So you can only invest in low density areas, so mainly in the interior of Portugal.
Gruner says these changes have put the pressure on, with investors from all over rushing in before the investment and property deals become less attractive. Laurel Bowman, VOA News, Washington.